Hey, what is going on, YouTube? It is your host, Sean, also known as the Prophet of Profit, and we are finally back again here today with the first of hopefully many quick due diligence videos that I plan on posting on this channel. This is the series where I'm just going to give a brief description of the company, what they plan on doing in the future, and then their outlook both short-term and long-term. I'm really only going to post videos about companies that I think have a very positive outlook in the future, so I think these are videos that are definitely worth watching. With that, the first company we are going to be taking a look at here today is Ocean Power Technologies, ticker symbol OPTT. OPTT is actually in the hottest sector year to date in 2021, which obviously is the energy sector. As you can see, the energy sector has outperformed every other industry, every other sector so far this year, with the likes of Fcell, Plug, etc., etc. So when it comes to what OPTT actually does, they are a pioneer in the renewable wave energy technology concept. So what that means is that they just take ocean wave energy, convert it into electricity that is then used for offshore and subsea applications. Obviously, this is a very cool concept, and it's also renewable energy, which fits the theme of the energy sector being hot this year. So I think this is going to have a strong outlook long term, not to mention the chart is absolutely amazing. So OPTT has three main products: the PB3 power buoy, the hybrid power buoy, and the subsea battery. Pretty much the power buoy system integrates patented technology in hydrodynamics, electronics, energy conversion, and computer control systems to extract natural energy from the ocean waves that could then be turned into electricity. So pretty much what that is saying is that their products are also autonomous, meaning they don't really need a lot of maintenance. So not only is their product beneficial to the environment, but it also does not require a lot of maintenance. Not to mention the chart on this stock, which we'll get to later in this video, looks absolutely mint. This, you see, you're catching my drift here. It's really starting to form one of the best opportunities I've seen in a minute. So to just explain this one more time, they have the PB3 power buoy and the hybrid power buoy. That is what actually converts the ocean wave energy into electricity. That is then stored in the subsea battery, which is their third product. So pretty much power buoy to subsea battery and renewable energy. Bang, boom. This is starting to look like one of the best opportunities I've came across in a minute. So say that doesn't do it for you. You're saying long term, you're saying to yourself, yeah, that looks like a great opportunity, but you know, I'm more of a day swing trader. I'm not patient like that. I can't hold for years, even knowing this company is going to be worth 10 times the amount it is right now, a few years down the road. Say that to yourself, you know? Well, guess what? The chart, as I said, is an absolute 10 out of 10, and we're going to get into that right now. So I'm actually going to meet you guys in Think or Swim momentarily, and we'll indulge right into this chart. We'll break down this chart and why I think this chart is going to be an absolute banger. At least I'd say, I don't like saying this, but I'm willing to say that this stock will run 100% within 2 months. So if you hold, if you put in a grand right now, you will have $2,000 in 2 months. You know, I usually don't like saying that because, you know, it puts pressure on me. And if it doesn't get there, people are going to be like, yo, Sean, what the? You know, but I really think, based off the renewable energy concept and the sector being hot, additionally, I'll get to this chart here 1 second. The chart being as good as it is, I really think within 2 months it could be over $8. And as of right now, the stock's in the 460s. So that's my bet there. So I will see you guys in Think or Swim. Hopefully you understand what I'm saying with the chart. If you don't, I'll try and put in simple terms for you. So I will see you guys in Think or Swim. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so here we are in Thinkorswim, and a little precursor before we start here is that I'm sorry if the audio sounded different or glitched a little previously in the video. One of the audio files I recorded before accidentally deleted for whatever reason. Couldn't figure that one out, so I'm sorry if the audio sounded different at a point for like a minute, but nonetheless, let's indulge in this chart here. So the first time frame, we're going to actually be looking at two time frames on this chart, is the 1 year, 1 day chart, and then the 4 hour, 180 day chart. So the first chart we're looking at is the 1 year, 1 day chart. So this is OPTT within the past year, with each candle representing 1 day. So when I'm looking at this chart, I'm looking for any noticeable patterns that come to mind when, you know, analyzing the chart as a whole. And as you can see, I'm going to zoom in here. The first pattern that I see within these past 6 months that happened on the daily chart was an ascending triangle. So look, so start right here. The stock was at 89 cents, right? The stock came up and peaked at a resistance point around, what, 370s? It pulled back. It found a low. It came up, and this time it went above that 370s resistance point, but there was a shooting star, so it pulled back. And then it proceeded to go make a higher low, right? So here's a low. Here's another low. You notice the second low is higher than the first low. And then here's a third low. And then it hit that same resistance point. You see this resistance price level that I have right here? So what we have is a high, a low. Technically speaking, the same high, a higher low. The same high, a higher low, and then a breakout. This pattern right here that my mouse is going over, that's called an ascending triangle. That is a very money pattern when you're looking at a chart, especially on the daily chart. And most of the time, as you can see on an ascending triangle, the stock ends up breaking out. You know, if you bought right here, three and the threes, low threes, high twos, and you're selling, you know, $7, you made 100% on your money. And this is only within the span of, you know, five trading sessions. So that is in the past, right? So what makes me think the stock is going to go higher in the future when looking at the chart? So as you can see, the stock went to $7.30 off this ascending triangle. So it made that high, right? And then it pulled back to what? $4. So a high, a pullback to $4. You know, that's over, what, a 60% pullback. And then from that low of $4, it made a push back to $6. So we have a high, a low, a lower high. So since this lower high at, you know, what is that, six tens, the stock pulled back all the way to 420s. So what this is showing me is that we have a high, a low, a lower high, and now a higher low. So you're probably asking, Sean, how do you know? So we're going to zoom in here. How do you know this is going to be the higher low? Well, right here, these two candles, this is called a bullish engulfing candle, or a bullish turnaround bar, or a bullish igniting candle. They're all the same things. What this shows is that the downtrend from sixes to 420s is about to reverse up. So what I think is going to happen here, you could see this on multiple time frames. So what I think is going to happen here is we have the high, as I said, the low, the lower high, the higher low. The stock's going to bounce up to this resistance trend line, pull back some, and then eventually within these, as I said, next month or two, the stock is going to break out, because this pattern is actually called a bullish pennant or a bullish flag. So we have an ascending triangle back here, breakout, into now a bullish pennant. This chart, I'm not even just saying this because I like the stock, but it genuinely cannot get much better than this. So as you can see, going back to the one-day chart, ascending triangle, breakout, into now a bullish pennant. It's actually, like, not trying to sound like a freak, but as someone who loves stocks, this is such a good, it's just a beautiful chart. So odds are, as I said, the stock is going to follow this resistance trend line. So it's probably these next few days, it's probably going to pop higher. Then it's going to pull back some. But eventually, it is going to break out of this bullish pennant. And when it breaks out of this bullish pennant, which is, as you can see, the top resistance is 730. It's going to break above that 730, which is why I think the stock will be $8 plus within the next few months. So that's pretty much the chart, an ascending triangle into a bullish pennant. The bullish pennant will break out and bring us higher, to make a long story short. And yes, this is the four-hour chart. As I said, we looked at the 180-day four-hour and the one-year one-day, so That is my opinion on the chart. That's why everything collectively here goes together for this stock. It's in one of the hottest sectors, renewable energy. And on top of that, this is an A-plus chart setup. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope my chart analysis wasn't too difficult to understand. As always, please do not forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Leave any opinions or thoughts you have in the comments. And as always, ladies and gentlemen, let's go make some money. That's why I do the best I can because I